Hello, I'm Stuart Mills, IPM Specialist at Fargro Limited, and in this video we're going to have a look at some of the commonly seen pests in soil and growing media. Before moving on to the main pests, I think it's worth just having a look at thrips, leaf miner and gall midges. Although not regarded as soil-borne pests, we can see from this life cycle of the western flower thrips that some do indeed have at least part of their life cycle in the compost or soil. This means that in the past some of the products we've been using, such as pesticides or biocontrols, would have been giving us at least some control. Springtails. Springtails are not really regarded as a major nuisance or pest, but they are found in large numbers in media and under pots, etc. They can sometimes be confused with thrips, but generally they are just a nuisance. However, occasionally they can feed on plant material. Root aphid and root mealybug are probably our first proper pests. You can see from the slide that they can cause checks in growth, wilting and even nutrient deficiency symptoms. When knocking out a pot or container, you'll often see a white waxy secretion on the side. Sometimes this can be confused with fungal growth. We see root aphids probably more commonly than mealybug, and root aphids will attack a wide range of crops, and we often see them on grasses. Root aphids are generally pear-shaped, dirty cream through to yellowish-white in colour, but sometimes even bluish-green. Spread is by nymphs crawling from pot to pot via irrigation holes. They can move in irrigation water, and winged adults will be produced that will go and lay eggs at stem bases. Root mealybug is often seen on houseplants. These are usually more elongated and flatter in shape. You can see on the left hand photo that the white waxy secretion is visible when the plant is knocked out. This can be confused with fungal growth, but it's only when you look closely, as in the right hand photo, that you actually see the small root aphids. Scarid flies. In the top left hand photo we can see the adult fly that is often seen flitting in paths and caught in high numbers on yellow sticky traps. In the bottom left hand photo the larvae is present with its distinctive black head and is up to about 10 mm in length. Larvae feed on roots and cuttings, even going up inside cuttings of forsythia and poinsettia for example. Larvae can even chew seedlings, soft stems or leaves, as can be seen in the top right hand photo. From this life cycle of scarid flies, we can see that there are large numbers of eggs laid by each female. And also at this sort of average temperature, the life cycle is very quick. Of course, warmer temperatures will mean a quicker life cycle. Slugs. On the right, we can see typical feeding damage. However, we need to know that most slugs will actually be living in the soil or media and just coming up to feed on leaves and shoots. When moving or knocking out pots, it is common to see their clusters of white eggs that have been laid. On potatoes and similar crops, slugs will be living and feeding in the soil, and because they are in the soil and media, nematodes can give very good control whilst allowing natural enemies to survive. Vine weevil have become a major pest again due to the loss of certain pesticides, so an integrated approach to their control is really needed. Adults are all female and can lay up to about 1,000 eggs, although most of these will never survive to become adults. Long lifespan of the adults means that egg laying can commence early in spring. The eggs are laid at random, and these, although white to begin with, soon darken, becoming very difficult to spot. In the top right hand picture we can see an adult female, and in the lower picture we can see the larvae with their distinctive brown heads and C-shape, but also one that is pupating. On the left we can see typical feeding damage on the leaf edges caused by the adults on begonia, and on the right on euonymus, both favourite plants for this pest to feed on. In the left hand photo we can see a crop of euonymus. You'll notice that some of the plants are showing new signs of growth whilst others have it discoloured with very little growth actually visible. When these plants were knocked out, it was found that the roots on the poorer plants had actually been eaten away, giving a lack of vigour. In the centre photo, we can see some nutritional deficiencies showing up, and this has most likely been caused by the larvae feeding on the roots. On the right hand photo, we have heuchera, another favourite plant for the actual vine weevil, and you can see a couple of larvae actually in the soil media there. What we tend to find with heuchera is that they will actually attack the roots, chewing them all off around the base. The plant loses vigour and becomes very loose in the pot. Chafer. Regarded as a pest of grass mainly, we do find the larvae in beds and containers causing quite extensive damage by feeding on the roots at times. Adult damage is often minor, however the adult rose chafer can cause extensive damage to rose flowers and leaves. The life cycle can be quite long, 1 to 4 years, but a lot of the damage to grass etc. can often be caused by predators actually trying to feed on the larvae when there. On the left we can see a typical adult chafer, which mainly will be out at night feeding. On the right we can see the larvae which causes the damage. These can be up to a couple of inches long, quite easily spotted by their C shape and very distinctive brown head. Leather jackets. With the loss of older pesticides, we see a lot more of this pest now. Like chafer, the larvae are regarded as a problem of grass, but are found more in pots and containers now, causing extensive root damage. On the top right, we have the larvae and a typical adult below. The life cycle is for the common European leather jacket seen in high numbers in the late summer in grass. This tends to have one generation a year. However, other types do have multiple generations per year, and these are the ones that we commonly find in pots and containers now. If you have any questions, please email us on stuartmills@fargro.co.uk or technical@fargro.co.uk. Thank you for watching.